Hello everybody, it is Zarbonga Gaming, as you know me, and I am now a part of a new channel. So yeah, we're gonna get into some Madden 21. This is the first series I'm gonna start. This is how we're gonna start this brand new channel off with a big bang. Sorry guys, I'm just, you know, at the time of this recording, I'm talking to another part of our members, Grantster. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, like, turn on post notifications so you don't miss out on any new series. We added a new guy. We added Master Stumpy. You guys know him. He was on the podcast. He is going to join our channel. We also have someone else new that will be going to join the channel as well. So moving on up here, but as of right now, it's just me, Grantster, and stuff. So
start your season with recommended settings. If you wish to change roles
Madden
or adjust options, use the tiles on the left.
And today, I'm going to be taking over head coach of the Denver Broncos.
Start the regular season by selecting your season goal.
And what this is going to be is a realistic franchise. I'm only going to make trades by those the trades need to be made.
Meeting your season goal comes with higher rewards.
And, you know, I'm going to be moderate. I say we are going to win 7 games this year. We're not quite ready to compete, but we aren't expecting a complete rebuild.
Start your week by installing your game plan.
Not rebuild worthy. And we start off with the Titans week 1. This is the real life schedule. So,
yeah.
I'm not going to start from when they start. I'm going to start from week 1. And, you know, every episode is going to be 1 game. 1 game. Just because, you know, this is a shorter season. But as my other series come along, like MLB The Show, that is going to be one series, one set of games per episode. So we're gonna head straight into it. I'm gonna show you what our team's gonna look like heading into this year. Our starting quarterback this year will be Drew Locke. Because, you know, Drew Locke, I really feel like he is going to be the main focus of this Broncos franchise. But really, the guy I'm really gonna focus on is none other than Philip Lindsay. Philip Lindsay is unbelievable. He is a great player, and he is definitely going to fit well with this Broncos lineup. Excuse me. You know, because about the fullback. Just kidding, I love fullbacks, but a wide receiver core. It is not very good. But guys, remember KJ Hamler from Penn State? He is on the Denver Broncos. Jerry Jeudy, the rookie wide receiver. I'm hoping to get him involved 100% of the court. tight end is going to be none other than Noah Fant. This is going to be rebuild. This would not be a fan series. It'll be another series that's going to be fan made. Depends on how much support we get. We will see there's Von Miller. I'm wanting Von Miller to play out his entire career with the Denver Broncos. That's what he's going to do. Middle linebacker will be Alexander Johnson. Again, a young guy. We have tons of young guys in the middle linebacker position. And of course, that right outside linebacker is none other than a cornerback. AJ Boye, Bryce Callahan, Michael Ochimendi, sorry if I say his name wrong, Devontae Harris, and Essing, Beasley. Free safety is none other than Justin Simmons. He is probably the best player on this defense other than Von Miller. And at strong safety is none other than Kareem Jackson. Our kicker is going to be Brandon McManus, and our punter is going to be Sam Martin. So you guys got to look at the team. We're just going to head straight into it now. Week one of the season. Broncos, Broncos, Titans. I want to get quick and straight into the point. I don't want to keep you guys waiting. I just want to push it as long as possible. I want to just make sure you guys get right into the action. Not trying to wait on anything. Welcome to, as of right now, probably when time this is uploaded, the channel name will be changed, and welcome to whoever that channel name is, but as I'm recording this, the channel name is all of Dynamic Duo, and it is, of course, going to be changed. Probably not before this video is uploaded, but the video, whenever this video is uploaded, welcome to that channel.
Time for football from Denver.
And here we
Broncos
go, Broncos
and Titans.
We are going to return it to...
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Broncos offense set to go behind their quarterback in his second season now from Missouri, Charles. It's Drew Locke.
What a roller coaster for Drew Locke from the NFL draft until the end of his rookie season, because on draft night he thought he was going to the first round, ended up going in the second, and then didn't get to start with the Broncos until the end of his rookie year. The Broncos did go 4-1 in those games, and he played very well, working on his agility and his pocket presence in the offseason.
There is a big run there. Going to get 11 weapons.
11 yards there. First down.
Every year we spend a lot of time and money evaluating the top prospects for the NFL draft. How about when we all get fortunate to see a guy like Philip Lindsay, an undrafted free agent, who had 1,000 yards rushing his first 2 years in the NFL, can run between the tackles, run with power, and catch the ball in the backfield.
The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first. So they go from 142 yard line to the other as they come up now first and 10. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 11 more on that one, and another first down. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. First and
10
at the 32-yard line. Lock on the give, it's Lindsay. And he was able to shed one tackle, but could not get away from there. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Pass caught by Jerry Judy, his first NFL catch. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Jerry Judy, his first NFL reception, goes for six. And the Broncos take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive.
The one that gets the first touchdown. for the Broncos.
Good throw there, and I don't want to blow it too out of proportion, but he looks a lot more comfortable in his second season.
You can tell he put the work in the offseason, and what I mean by that is understanding the playbook, not just the plays and how to execute them, but how to do it against a variety of defenses, also understands his team better, what they can and cannot do. You can see the confidence rising in him as he plays.
Boom. We kick it off here after that amazing first drive for Denver.
And yeah, they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Here comes the Tennessee offense, and we see Ryan Tannehill leading them out.
Not only did Ryan Tannehill resurrect his career in 2019, he may now serve as a blueprint for quarterbacks looking for a second opportunity. He moved from Miami to Tennessee, took over starting job for Marcus Mariota in week 7 last year, and wound up leading the NFL in quarterback rating. And the Titans went 8-3 in his 11 starts, snuck into the playoffs, and went to the AFC Championship game. His future is bright in Nashville, and he expects to be the starter there for many years to come.
If we do, we do.
They're going to turn and give this to Henry.
Sheds
a second man.
He's built up some momentum, isn't he?
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11. Out of the gun, Tannehill. And that is incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage. And just like that, they're staring at a 4th down. Well done.
On his Kern, the punter, to send this one away.
Are shortened, so the game is going by quicker.
Well, that a 49-yard punt, but a net of just 39 following the 10-yard return. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. Lock and the Broncos going to come up first and 10 at the 33-yard line.
Make it longer.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Denver Broncos.
Here we go.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
Lock now on first down. This is the tight end fan. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
He's going to be holding on the Denver Broncos. Lloyd,
so a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Here's a first down throw that's complete, and he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
100 yards total.
At their 48-yard line.
On second down, it's Lenzing, and nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
I think after what we saw today,
he's got his big tight end fan.
At the time of this reporting,
and he'll get it down to the 47 here.
Horrible.
They'll get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down.
In punt formation for the Broncos.
And here now the punter Martin booming this one away.
Broncos fan, I am a Viking.
And there's a work of art right there. Out of bounds at the 2-yard line. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports.
Titans,
nothing.
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry.
Way back.
And he'll get him a little bit of breathing room across the 5 to the 6-yard line.
Henry, the ball carrier.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
A gain of 5 brings up 2nd and 5 at the 6-yard line.
Derrick Henry. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10 right around the 9-yard line.
I just want to talk
now a timeout being called as there's an injured Titan down on the field. But hate to see this. Week 1 of the season. We'll be back. They'll try to run for the first one, Henry. And they're going to get the first down here as he's up to the 14. Give him the 3rd down conversion. 5 yards on the play. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Go after a high.
Now it's Henry. And a nice game there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20.
Mike Marcel.
That's a really nice job by then picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. A lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Again, nice carry there by Derrick Henry. Picks up a first down. And when you say workhorse, you're thinking about Derrick Henry. Won the rushing title in 2019. 1,540 yards on the ground and 16 rushing touchdowns. Went to his first Pro Bowl and carried his team to the AFC Championship game.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 49-yard line. Tannehill throwing complete to Davis. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
10 yards.
Good position to be in here, second and inches.
At the 39-yard line.
They'll run the jet sweep with Brown. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. That one a first down pickup of 8.
Looking to win their third.
Well, we've seen running backs in today's NFL get involved in the passing game. Maybe it's about time more receivers like that get involved in the running game.
And that is something we are seeing more and more in this league, no question about it. That wasn't the biggest of gains. That was enough to get them a first down. And it continues to test the defense. That think on every play about who might end up with the ball.
So that flag will cost him 15.
It doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it is going to be 15 yards.
The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. From the gun, here's Tannehill. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kareem Jackson.
This may be a pick six.
And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown.
What a way for this defense.
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using 5 defensive backs, 6 defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there. And what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This is becoming a passing league. And because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
McManus's point after is good, and that'll make the score 14-0. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
As we kick it back to Tennessee.
And as we see so frequently here in Colorado, that one over the end line. So
after that pick
to the
6, the Denver defense is just going to have to get
Tannehill
right
and the Titans come up now
field.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The offense will be very appreciative of that because the offense has been playing very well.
And he'll get 2 or 3 out of that one as that is going to take us to the 2-minute warning.
This is how the defense is going to play.
3 yards on the pick up there and it'll be second down.
I can see
why you coming up at halftime. We'll hand things off to the coach, Jonathan Coachman, in Orlando. He'll have a look back at a very intriguing opening weekend in the NFL. A throw over the middle, taken in, and he's going to be down at the 35. Gain of 7.
Being a ceiling for Denver.
From the gun on third down,
they are a good team.
The open man is Smith.
A good team.
Tannehill's pass.
First down now, but that clock rolling.
Really showed that.
On first down, Tannehill. Smith catches left side.
Tannehill's pass.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. It just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
Oh, and he's going to get this inside the 30. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half.
Here comes the blitz. We miss on the tackle.
And that one finds the ground, breaking a string of five straight completions. And it brings up second down. No third. Third down. Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a third and three.
They're dead.
Throwing again is Tannehill.
And just like that, Tennessee strikes right before the half.
AJ Brown there to make the grab. And the Titans are able to make this a close game again. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, headed into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played. Denver offense at the line, first, ready to go. You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try to move the ball and get field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I like where they are in the field. Got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up and go into halftime looking at each other wondering what if.
He was looking to go back to Sutton there, and it's second down. Line of scrimmage again, the 37 as they line up second and 10.
You are able to throw over the middle, and that's what we do. And it's picked.
Judy, but it's intercepted.
It's intercepted. And Denver's not able to tackle.
Back at the closing stages of the first half.
See, that's the issue with throwing over the middle. I thought they were going to open that seam over the middle, but they didn't.
After the interception, here's Tannehill.
And Von Miller makes
him
sure
that
that throw
was
not going
to
be complete.
He was trying to get it to A.J. Brown that time, and now it's second down.
This is good for Tennessee.
For this offense, we're taking a look at the draft class here. They were looking for a playmaker, and they found one on the outside.
Football!
You can't afford to skip the wide receiver position.
Tennessee.
I know that the slot guy's getting more attention now.
But we are going to ice the kicker.
And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points.
And the kick is up, and
it
the
14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through
at halftime.
All right, we will save the week one highlights and apparently get right back to the action here in the third.
To kick off for Denver.
We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half.
But the defense did
fielded near the back of the end zone. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally.
Good play.
I'm guessing in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up.
Whoa,
get about three here as he's out to the 30.
There's another
Tennessee called as there's an injured
down.
Titan down on the field.
I
hate to see this
another
week one of the season. We'll be back.
So Denver,
a shotgun snap for Tannehill. They find
what a hit over the middle.
He will have the first down, but he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time.
Adam Humphries.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
And he's got some space here. And he'll be out
they
of bounds just
gonna
shy of the 40. That good for 19 and a first down.
Something to watch
Denver
here in week one of the season.
Tackling.
Because you're
not happy
both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole
already
lot.
Plus
the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
We are going to make sure
forward for a couple down inside the 40.
Of 2 yards.
You know that old expression, it's not my night, It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough day.
So used to
every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
Vaughn Miller.
Throwing on third down. He's got his tight end, Anthony Furkser.
We rallied to the
and he's going to be stopped really here a few yards short of first as the tackle is made at the 33.
Like to see it.
So much about offense is what you call hitting the yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch.
That was not an option.
They did a really nice job there limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Now stopped him in his tracks. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth.
A pickup of 2 yards. First down, Tennessee.
They keep it with Henry on first down.
Oh, look at that.
And he stopped immediately there.
That was A.J.
Boye up to make the tackle. His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action. But other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw.
Oh,
into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Bryce Callahan. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in. Coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
After the turnover, here's Locke. And he's going to have the hook up for Sutton.
The pass. Great.
And they'll get him down here at the 23. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Shotgun snap and a give to Lansing. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 11 yards there, first down.
I know people see Philip Lindsay's role in Denver is changing a bit with the arrival of Melvin Gordon. I think Gordon's going to be more of an enhancement for Lindsay. Maybe he won't carry it as often, but now he'll be much more effective as a two-headed monster in the backfield. Both of them can run it inside, get to the perimeter, and catch the ball at the backfield and move the sticks.
Brings up second and seven.
Faking the give to Lindsay. Here's Locke rolling to his right. Now he'll let it go deep right side.
Oh, but there is a
flag
down. And
that's going to wind
down.
Up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down.
And they
let's
are
check in with a referee.
Pass interference.
You won't hear any boos from this home crowd on that call.
No, not at all. And it's been a long day for this crowd waiting for this game. It's been a long evening as well. Finally, they feel they got a call.
Oh, boring.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
The 27-yard line. A gain of five brings up second and five.
On second down, a run with Lindsay. And he is going to get this close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the Titans 22. Welcome back now to Denver. It's Bronco football, and they also have the lead here as we get set for the fourth. They'll try and run for it with Lindsay. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. They have the first down with that gain of 4 yards. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Into the red zone, it's Locke. Out quickly to Judy. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Giving 9 there on the first down completion. Line of scrimmage, the 9. Second and about a yard.
I use Melvin Gordon. Melvin Gordon
fights up for a Denver touchdown.
Touchdown, Denver.
A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Broncos will add on to their lead.
Melvin Gordon.
People always talk about one of his biggest strengths, running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
And his kick is right through. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it's capped off by a touchdown run coming from Melvin Gordon.
Kickoff for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away.
is the main.
Now this will make it into the end zone. And no there. Effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical.
And we were all over
first down there, but it's incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often miss time that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well. Like, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You tackle him almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra.
Accelerating, and off he goes.
And he is gone.
Touchdown Titans.
AJ
Brown,
already
his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Titans have made this a one-score game.
And they need to, and that is make
so plays. That's a really big play here in the fourth quarter. And don't look there's now, a they're right back conversion. In this game.
Did it feel to you, as it did to me, that maybe they were a little bit soft in what they were lining up with on defense? Almost like they were protecting the lead rather than trying to make a play.
And now that lead is down to just one score. And Spencer will elect to not bring it out here. It's a touchback. Denver's offense ready to go again. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. Some pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy.
Throwing
on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. He was looking to go back to Sutton there. That'll bring up second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Third down,
possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Here's Locke.
Lock.
Screen pass to Lindsey.
Kicks it to Lindsey.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Somehow he stayed in.
Good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third.
That's very good. Very good of Lindsey to stay inbounds.
On first and 10, it's Lindsey. And give him about five as he gets this up to the 48-yard line. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this. They describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
At least it's a change.
He's
there's
got
Sutton,
the first down here
inside open.
The 30. And
Sutton
down to the 19-yard line. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
So
it's Bronco football as we get your reset here. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off.
Tennessee out of it just yet.
And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away.
Locked
to throw. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
And his guys will take a 10-point lead. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it ends with a Denver touchdown.
Ooh, what a thought. Denver coming
after the touchdown,
here.
Here's McManus now to kick it away.
Start off the season and them doing this.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
Pay attention more.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter for us up here in the booth. It's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Points
certainly not
at
a premium here. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first.
What we're doing as we get the first sack of the
Jarrell Casey in there to drop him as that clock continues to run.
Jarrell Casey plays this game with passion and aggression as well as great intelligence, and he's been awfully consistent as well. At least 5 sacks each year since 2013, 9 seasons previously in Tennessee, the last 5 as a Pro Bowl defensive tackle.
Yeah, as I said, multiple channels.
And a throw there going to be incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers.
Every single day, and we're not going to win.
On a fourth down, this one is going to wind up incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and defensively, that might just seal a week one victory. And he's got
Philip Lindsay. What's an exclamation point!
And he'll take it into the end zone. Philip Lindsay, 36 yards.
Tennessee fans will not be very happy with that.
I think all teams probably like seeing that schedule for the first time. Looking at week one, oh good, we're at home. This is why you want to be home in week one. They're looking sharp.
And I agree with you totally. That's what you want, but there carries a little extra pressure with that as well because you and I both know protecting the home field, winning your home games is paramount in this league. So you go into it, yeah, we want it, but now you actually have to go out and prove it.
Got two sides to that coin and looking like they're going to protect it here in this one. Extra point from McManus is good.
Like a fantasy.
That'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17.
What is going to be
after the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away.
Within this Madden game,
that'll be taken
I'll
about a yard
more
deep.
Games.
And he returns this to the 22.
And then I will show you guys the schedule so you guys could be like, hey, can you do commentary for this game?
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And no doubt this is not the way that they had hoped to open their season. Thoroughly outplayed here in front of the national audience. That's complete to his tight end, Firkser. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Henry's got it out on the left side.
Oh, what did this player do?
Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout. As he'll stop him with 13 seconds left to play. Throwing again on second down. Tannehill out to the right to Humphreys. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
It's a gain of six.
Brings up third and inches. Tannehill on third down. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked by the rookie Michael O.J. Mooney. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Block now to throw.
So I'm pretty sure this game is over.
Got a man open.
We're going to throw one more pass.
Yeah, he's
going to
be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. So this will wind up a Denver victory. And partner, I must say, good to see you again.
There it is, our first
win
in the books for
Denver.
We had three interceptions.
Yeah, preseason, you know, it's preseason. This is week one.
Are you trying to say real football? Not preseason football, where we shake down the rosters and figure out who's going to play, and maybe the starters don't play as much. Now it's the frontline guys
showing this division.
I tuned you out in the preseason.
Denver may have been bad, but this
so
team
for the Broncos,
could be a threat.
It's a great win here on a Monday night as they'll start the new campaign 1-0. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Drew Lock with a completion percentage of 181.22.
They go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves next week at home against Jacksonville.
Yeah, guys, that's going to be it for this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure you like, subscribe to the channel. Because, hey, this channel is going to have tons of different sports content that I feel like
the players on quickly upgrade your team at the end of each game.
With that this is the said, player card.
Here you can see your player strengths and weaknesses.
Sorry, I got chess coming in. Realize like a this guy is not even. My new captain. Yeah, thank you guys so much for joining. And this is Ben. Time to destroy.